There really is. And I've got one off the top that I've been thinking about and I want to ask you about, all right?
Okay, fire away.
All right, let's start with the hard stuff. Where is it? All right, here we go. In quantum theory, certain physical systems can become entangled, meaning their states are directly related to the state of another object somewhere else. When one object is measured and the Schrodinger wave function collapses into a single state, that's complicated, the other object collapses into its corresponding state no matter how far away the objects are. In other words, non-locality. Is that a fair description?
That's right. Einstein hated this concept, but hey, he was wrong on this one.
Oh, he was wrong?
We measure this effect in the laboratory all the time, that interactions are in fact non-local. Einstein thought that the universe was local, that is, all effects are transmitted to nearby objects, not objects over a distance instantaneously. But hey, what can I say? You know, we do this in the laboratory every day.
Okay, but nobody understands. What it comes down to is this, really, folks. If you think of two particles and you get them together and they're flipping and flopping, well, once they've come together, their flips and flops are going to be exactly the same. It doesn't matter if one's in New York and one's in Moscow. Is that correct, Doctor?
That's right. If you take two electrons and bring them together so they vibrate in unison, and then you separate them, an invisible umbilical cord connects them no matter how far they are separated. You can separate them to the ends of the galaxy, and you vibrate one, and in some sense, the other one is aware of the fact that it's attached to an object on the other side of the galaxy. Amazing.
That's more than amazing. I think Einstein said spooky something at a distance.
Yeah, spooky action at a distance, said Einstein.
Okay, but it's not possible. I mean, without communication of A and B, how would they know to flip it and flop at exactly the same point? They're doing a dance together, but they're not communicating.
Well, in some sense, they are. Electrons spin up and down. So if you know that one electron is spin up, then its partner is going to be spin down. But if you separate them and you measure the spin of one electron and it's down, then instantly, faster than the speed of light, you now know that an object on the other side of the galaxy is spin up, which is amazing. It's astounding.
It's amazing and astounding, but Professor, I'm a ham radio operator, and I can transmit 1,500 watts through a very effective antenna from here to Moscow, let's say, and I'm going sublight, not light speed, but sublight, a little bit. And so there is communication, but it takes me a big transmitter, a giant antenna, and I may or may not be heard in Moscow. My point is, how are they talking?
Well, we don't know. We just know that spin is conserved, so that if one electron has spin up, the other one has spin down, so the total sum is zero. But if you separate them, the memory of them being attached stays with them, even though you separate them over light years. And if you measure one being spin up, the other one is automatically spin down, and you now know that faster than the speed of light. Now, Einstein, of course, hated that idea, going faster than the speed of light, but we do this in the laboratory. Now, there is a catch, however. Einstein, in some sense, has the last laugh. It turns out that the information you send across this process is random information. That is, you cannot send Morse code this way. But in some sense, everything is entangled. Every atom of your body, in some sense, is entangled with another atom on the other side of the galaxy. Which is amazing if you think about it.
It is, but the bottom line is still we don't fully understand it at all, right?
Right. However, quantum teleportation, a la Star Trek, is a direct consequence of this effect. And this has now been demonstrated at the University of Austria, also Caltech, University of Maryland, many places. And quantum teleportation, a la Star Trek, that is teleporting Captain Kirk from one place to another, may eventually be possible. We already teleport atoms now. Individual atoms can also be connected using this method of entanglement so that, the atom here can exchange information to another atom on the other side of the galaxy.
So we can teleport atoms, yes?
Yes, we teleported photons. The world's record is, I think, 600 meters for teleporting photons. And we now can teleport atoms, cesium atoms, rubidium atoms. This is now something that we do in the laboratory.
Okay, well, let me just wait until they've really got it down before I volunteer for an entire body move.